Hi, it's Shield Dixon here, and I am thrilled that you can join me for another installment of Mystical Thinking with Rashiel Dixon. I'm also the host of the podcast, You Are God. Click the link below and come and have a listen. It's something special. I guarantee you'll love it. If you caught the last video on the simple principles to manifesting, then that means you caught something that is very helpful in letting you understand these principles. This mental science isn't for the faint of heart. Who is it for? It's for the individual that know that they are the source of life. Or better yet, the source of life flows through them. And they can give life to anything that they lend this source to. It's for the person who is willing to develop and cultivate their patience. Because as the saying goes, patience is a virtue. And what is the true meaning of virtue? It's defined as a behavior having a high moral standard or something having a good quality. Strength, a benefit to put it clearly. Anything or anyone that is virtuous will always be an asset. The virtue that is in you is an asset that will always give you strength and empowerment. What's true about this is that when you seek a new level of inner calm, it will be your friend in times of need. The big problem that restrains so many from getting anything that they want or making any leeway is the fact that they have no understanding of who they are or what they want. Yes, everyone says that they want success or they want this, but the reason why only a few achieve their goals is because that few are the relentless types who won't allow their virtue to be blocked or cut short by some problem that might arise. This mental discipline is phenomenal because the student who takes it seriously and really lives by the values of these principles will go on to conquer and create their own opportunity in this thing called life. They will be able to turn to their incredible human imagination and see that within it lives their connection to the divine. If you were to ask the average person about the divine or divinity, I am sure you will get various answers. But the only thing that would probably remain consistent is the fact that they would point to some outside source beyond themselves. Now, ask the mystic who lives by these principles about the divine, and you will find someone who will point to themselves or describe to you how them and the divine are one, are unified as one force. It sounds easy putting this together, but so many forget these concepts. You still have some who call on every god or deity from whatever book they might come across, forgetting that all those deities are creations from the imagination of some other individual. That's true. But the Lord is a true God. He is the living God and an everlasting King. At his wrath, the earth shall tremble, and the nations shall not be able to abide his indignation. Jeremiah 10:10. The living God is living and never dead, because this living God lives in every human being. The Lord is an authority, which is your imagination. It is a king that rules over you. And the kingdom that lives in you is a monarchy that you set up properly when you know these teachings. The earth trembling is a metaphor showing the feelings one has based on the outcomes of what you have imagined. No nation or no individual's emotions shall be able to abide the indignation of their own imagination. Indignation means anger or annoyance based on what is perceived to be unfair treatment. How many times have you or someone you know have been annoyed or angry with life because they felt like life was unfair or treated them unfairly? Ever had a feeling like, how comes everyone else is able to advance except for you? So that's why it's important to know the value of your imagination and the value that you have. Quite often, many won't have a good sense of their value, and they won't know who they are, and they'll lower their own self-worth. Just look around and you will see this. It's appearing in all areas of society. Some people lack confidence in themselves, and you can tell just by the tone of their voice. and how they refuse to look a person directly in their eyes. So let's discuss the look in the eyes and how important it is. As the saying goes, the eyes are the window to the soul. The eyes of a person can tell everything. And by the way that a person looks at you, you can determine everything. You can even inflict your own will on a person by the way that you look in their eyes. So let us discuss the apple of my eye and how to control another just by looking in their eyes. This mystical concept can allow you to gain favor when you need it the most. You might want to seduce that man or woman and want it to go in your favor. You might get pulled over by the police and want it to go in your favor, as the eyes can give you everything that you want. I am sure you heard the term apple of my eye. Most will use the term to signify a person who they see as their love interest, unaware of the original meaning or where the term comes from. Let's look at the verses that speak about this. Keep my commandments and live, and my law as the apple of thine eye. Proverbs 7:2. Now let's look at Psalms 17:8. Keep me as the apple of the eye. Hide me under the shadow of thy wings. And for thus saith the Lord of hosts, after the glory hath he sent me unto the nations which spoiled you. For he that toucheth you toucheth the apple of his eye. Zechariah 2:8. He found him in a desert land, and in the waste howling wilderness. He led him about, he instructed him, he kept him as the apple of his eye. Deuteronomy 32:10. These verses speak of the importance of the apple of the eye, which comes from the word Ishan, which means pupil of the eye. It also means a little man, referring to the reflection of yourself that you see in the pupil of the eyes of another. The apple of your eye is the little man, or you seeing yourself within the pupil of another. That's what it originally means. And when you look directly into the eyes of another, you see the reflection of God, which is your reflection in their eyes. And when they look in your eyes, they can see God, which is their reflection in yours. This little man goes about our society shining in the eyes of everyone. And only to the trained mystic will they know about this and know what to do with this little man. This is why it's important to look directly in someone's eyes if you want to gain favor. And all you have to do is look at the little man and pay close attention to him or her, as you will be looking at your own reflection in their eyes. As long as you please the apple of your eye, then you can impose your will on another. Make the little man happy by only focusing on the reflection that you see in the pupil of another. You must get so focused that it's almost like you forget that you're talking to another person. And only the apple of your eye should be your focus. And bring your imagination into the mix by making the apple of your eye happy. Make it as if you go in a trance-like state. If you do this with complete volition, then the person that you're speaking to will fall putty in your hands. To them, they will see you looking them directly in their eyes. And it will be like they're looking directly into your soul. And they won't even have a clue of what is going on, but you will. As long as you're aware and pay attention to what you're doing, then you will impose your will. This is a phenomenal tactic, so employ your imagination correctly with it. And by them saying or going in the direction that you want them to, it's you getting things done in your favor. Never force this, or allow yourself to get so enthralled in your emotions that you allow your emotions to take over. Remain calm and at peace, but still hold on to a level of high confidence. You know, calm confidence is everything. And with it being everything, you will see how it will be your everything. Remember to make sure that your breathing is calm and controlled as always, and not all over the place. Practice makes perfect. So if you aren't successful the first time, don't beat yourself up. Just know that with practice, you will get better. You're training your mind here to obey your command. So over time, you will get to the point where you need to be from this training. As always, test it for yourself and make a note of your results and where you want to improve. Remember that. I thank you all for joining me. May you all continue to perfect your craft. If you need more help and want to read the more in-depth teachings regarding this and many other mystical teachings, please come and stop by mindworthyinfo.com. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button here and subscribe to the channel. And hit that bell icon so you never miss a new video. The conversation and the teachings, as always, is continued over at the podcast, You Are God. So click the link below to go over there and have a listen. I just want to say that one-on-one coaching is now available. So if you want more in-depth and guided teachings directly to you, reach out to me and we could have a coaching session and we can get your mind more programmed to these teachings and you will see phenomenal results. As always, know thyself, because with knowing thyself, you will always know the divine. Until next time, have a great one and may all great things come to you. Bye for now. Now, let us go into the silence. I'm gone. Bye.